जय गुरुदेव डियर स्टूडेंट्स चिल्ड्रन यू नो वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड आवर चैप्टर नंबर 1 न्यूट्रिशन इन प्लांट्स सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर नंबर 2 न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल्स सो अंडर दिस चैप्टर चिल्ड्रन वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द एनिमल न्यूट्रिशन इन दिस चैप्टर We will study the nutrition pattern in various animals and we will start from the primitive type of animals means very small structured animals just like amoeba. Okay, so we will study about the small animals also and in case of large animals also so let's start our chapter with this small activity here they have written that different animals eat different things here are some pictures of animals can you name the type of food they eat so children here they have given picture of some animals and they ask to write the food what type of food they eat so here they have given blank columns okay so I have written some words here you can see this is a tiger you know so tiger eat flesh of other animals so here I have written flesh and this is deer deer always eat plants So here plants will come and bear, this is a panda we can say and panda likes to eat bamboo, okay and this is crow and crow generally they are omnivores animal and they like to eat plants as well as animal products means if we give any plant product to them then also they can eat and they also consume the leftover dead bodies of other animals okay so children this is a small kind of activity which they have given here before the starting of the chapter because This chapter is based on nutrition. So here also you can see different animals. Here four animals they have given and they are also having different pattern of nutrition. Okay. So in the same way, let's start with our chapter. The basic activities which all living organisms perform are called life processes. So children, what are the life processes? Whatever activities are performed by different organisms they are called as life processes means to live alive whatever activities basic activities performed by any organism they are coming under the life processes so under life processes nutrition is also one of the process growth reproduction digestion these all are respiration these all are the life processes okay so without these processes any organism can't complete their life activities okay so to perform these life processes we require a continuous supply of energy this energy comes from food through nutrition so children to complete these all the life processes whatever I have told you means those all the reactions or those all the processes which are continuously taking place inside our body they all require energy continuous supply of energy okay so from where this energy comes This energy comes from the food through the nutrition. Whatever food we eat, we get energy from that food. So the process of taking and utilizing food for growth and maintenance is known as nutrition. So children, in the previous chapter also, means chapter number 1 also, we have learnt this definition of nutrition. So here also same definition you can write under this chapter also. Means it is the process in which any organism take and utilize food for what purpose? For growth and maintenance. So this process is called as nutrition. Chapter 1 helped you learn how plants obtain nutrition. In chapter 1, children, we have studied in detail that how the plants obtain nutrition. Okay, in that chapter we have studied about two type of nutrition, two modes of nutrition. One was the autotrophic and second was the heterotrophic. Okay, so do you know how you obtain nutrition from food? Means in this chapter we will study about how we obtain nutrition from food. Okay, whatever food we used to eat, how that food provide us energy and under what different steps food going through. Okay, so what happens to food inside your belly? In this chapter you will learn how animals including humans derive their nutrition from food. So children, under this chapter we will learn this journey of food only. Okay, so means how different type of animals or including human beings also, how they derive or how they get their nutrition, and from that nutrition how it will convert into energy. Understood? And now nutrition in animals. Animals cannot make their own food. This we know already. All the animals are heterotrophs because they can't prepare their own food. So they rely on other animals or plants to acquire their nutrition. So that's why all other animals or plants means they depend on other animals or plants for their food. This mode of nutrition is heterotrophic. So children, this mode of nutrition is called heterotrophic because in the last chapter also I have taught you that if any of the organism, whether it is plant or animal, if it will not able to prepare its food from the simpler substances, then that organism comes under the category of heterotroph. Okay, so all the animals are heterotroph and they are showing heterotrophic nutrition. Our body cannot utilize the food or drink as it is. The food materials are broken down into simple usable form. The food we eat undergoes a few important steps to turn into substances that the body can use. Now children, what is the meaning of this paragraph? They are trying to explain us that whatever food we used to eat, like you take milk, okay, so in the form of milk or paneer, in the form of milk or paneer, our body can't accept it, okay, because it is the complex form of food. So our body need nutrient from our food. So that nutrients are going to our body, going to our blood, even we can say, after the breaking down into simpler substances. Means very small, or we can say simple usable form, when they break down, then it can be used by our body. Okay, so that's why it requires some steps, few important steps. So our food undergoes some important steps to turn into substances that the body can use. So what are these steps? First step is ingestion. Ingestion means it is the process of taking food into the body. So children, ingestion means when we keep food in front of us in a plate, then we pick with our hand or with the help of spoon and we put in our mouth. In case of humans, I am telling you, if we put food in our mouth either with the hand or with the help of spoon, that process is called as ingestion. So different animals adopt different type of ingestion processes. Okay, some of them you can see the variety of animals. If we see, then some of the animals, they use their hands or their limbs to put food in their mouth. But some of the animals, they use their tongue to catch the food, or some of the animals, they use directly their mouth part to take the food. So different ingestion processes are there in case of different animals. So second process is digestion. When we take food, when we put food in our mouth, then ultimately food goes to our stomach through the esophagus, means through our food pipe. So when it reaches to the stomach, then it undergoes digestion. Digestion is the breakdown of food into simple substances which can be absorbed by the body. So children, what is digestion? Digestion means whatever food we put in our mouth, that food when break down into simpler substances, that much simpler substances which can be easily absorbed by our body. Body means blood. Through blood, that food material or nutrient, they reach to our different cells. Understood? So that process of breakdown of food into simpler substances is called digestion. Okay, these all the processes we will study in case of human beings in detail, but here just I am giving you introduction of this nutrition, means how nutrition goes to our body. Okay, so second process is digestion. Next, third process is absorption. Now food is digested, means completely. After the digestion, what will happen? Absorption is the transport of digested food particles, that is nutrients and water, in the tissues of the body. Now absorption, you can understand from this term absorption. Absorption means to take in, to take inside the body, means in tissues, in cells. So when food is digested and it will convert into nutrients, that nutrients transport along with the water in our different tissues. Okay, in different body parts, when where all the cells or tissues are present, in that part all the nutrients can reach after digestion. Okay, so now they reach to our each and every body part. The process is called absorption. And fourth is assimilation. Children, what is assimilation? Now absorbed food, now it is present in our tissues or cells. What are the tissues, children? You already studied in junior classes, but again I want to tell you what are the tissues. Tissues are the group of cells which perform same function. All the cells when perform the same function and they have similar structure, then we can say that group of cell is called tissues. Okay, these are the cells only, but similar kind of cells are called, group of similar kind of cells are called tissues. So when food reached to the tissues, that time food is now present in the tissues, and after that, how this food will be utilized in our body, what is the use of food, or what function that food perform in the body, that is called assimilation. Okay, so assimilation is the movement of the absorbed nutrients from the digestive system into different regions of the body for energy, growth, and maintenance of health. So children, here you can understand that our food perform different functions. It provide energy to our body, so that work also it does, and in the separate way it also helps in the growth of the body, growth of different parts of our body. So here it performs the function of growth also, and somewhere inside or outside the body, when anywhere old cells they die out and new cells will be formed, and whenever any injury happens to our body parts, that time also it maintains. Okay, so food helps to maintenance also of health. So we become healthy only because of nutritious food. Understood? So it means our food perform different functions in different regions of the body. So that process is called assimilation. Means after absorption, now food move from one place to another according to the need of our different body part. Now fifth is egestion. Now children, egestion is a process in which the waste food products, means when nutrition is or nutrients are absorbed by the body, then after that some leftover waste food, or which is called undigested, the part of food which is undigested and it is not digested by our body, that waste food is eliminated from the body, means it is removed from the body. That process is called egestion. Okay, means waste products are removed from the body of every living organism. That process is called as egestion. Okay, so children, under these five steps, or we can say these are the main five steps, under these steps all the living organisms, or we can say under animal category, all they perform these five steps. Okay, so next, all animals do not take in or digest food the same way. Now children, if we talk about the lower category of animals, they do not digest or take food in the same way what I have explained you. So complex organisms have special organs in their body to ingest, digest, absorb, and assimilate food. Means, if we talk about the higher category of animals, like cow or dog, cat, buffaloes, even elephant, and human beings also, they have some special organs for all these processes. Means these all the five processes are performed by different type of organs of their body. Okay, means different part is there to ingest the food, different part in our body is to digest the food, and different part is there to absorb the food and assimilate the food also. Okay, so birds have beaks to peck food. So here they have given example, like birds. You can see birds have no hands and they are using their beaks to peck food, means to pick the food, to break it. A giraffe can pull some leaves and small twigs from a tree, a tall tree, into its mouth using its lips and tongue, and begins to chew. So see, giraffe is a big animal, but even then also giraffe it pulls, or we can say it plucks, leaves or small twigs with the help of its lips and tongue only. Means it uses its mouth parts to take the food and then it chew the food. And a frog uses its long sticky tongue. And frog, what ingestion process frog uses? It uses its long sticky tongue to catch insects. Its tongue is so sticky, and when it wants to catch the insects, it takes out and withdraw its tongue, and insects can easily stick with that sticky tongue. Okay, so in the same way, a mosquito uses its feeding tube to suck in blood. Means for mosquito, blood is a food, so it uses its feeding tube. Tube-like structure is present in its mouth, which is used to suck the blood. Okay, so you can see here also different animals uses its different way to take the food in. Means this we are talking about the process of ingestion. Okay, so children, up to here today I conclude my class, because it's already 23-24 minutes video. So children, you can understand that how different organism used to take help of different their body parts to take food, to ingest the food. Okay, so after this we will study these all the processes in so detail, that how different organisms take nutrition. Okay, here they have given about the hydra, amoeba. These are the lower category organisms, means small organisms, and how they use to take nutrition and how nutrition process takes place in them, that we will study in the next class. So main processes you try to understand from this video, what I have taught you today, because these all the processes are important processes. If you not understand these things, you can't understand the chapter. Okay, so try to understand again and again what I have taught you. So Jai Gurudev.